Welcome back to the channel. Today's video, I'm going to show you some visual effects. So let's jump in and check them out. First one I want to show you is the grid warper. So under your effects library, if you type in warp and choose this warper, we're going to drop it on a node here. There's some on-screen controls with how it's going to interact. So let me just add a point here. Once you drop this plugin on, you can click on the screen. You'll get this little gray dot right here. That's a warp point. Now, if you're wanting a grid, there is a reference grid right here, which sort of shows you points. So if you like that, you can add that under on-screen controls. Now, if we grab this point and start warping, you can see that the edge of the screen here stays intact. And that's because we're on warp limits corners. So you can choose the different versions. Here's one for the edge, which means the edges will stay the same. So depending on what you need to do, then we have a distance, which sort of is between your two points. How's it going to warp? And that'll warp everything. So it depends on what you're looking for. And then we have manual, and that kind of lets you freeform everything. And then there's sharpness. This one's called rubber sheet. There's another one that's sharp, so it's a little more precise. And we have another one that's rounded, and that depends on, once again, how you pull your warp. So I'm going to reset everything. We do have quality and a warp scale if you want more warping and a couple other things. But I'm going to show you what I was wanting to show you with the effect now that we looked at some of the controls. Now, you can make a safe zone, and if we look down here, there's a warp boundaries. Right now, it's on none by default. And then we have as a border or a mask. So I'm going to make a safe zone around his face because I don't want anything out here to be warped. I'm just looking to warp some things on his face. So I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to hit shift. And you can see we're making this off-colored, kind of reddish-colored circle. And that's our boundary. So I'm just drawing an outside here. And now if we add a regular point, let's add a couple to each eye. So now we have some warp points on the image, and if I change warp boundaries to border, it's going to show you the outline we made. So anything outside the border is safe. And then if we go mask, it kind of looks like the magic mask type thing. I'll go ahead and switch it back to none. Just I wanted to show you that exists. So now what I'm going to do is exaggerate the eyes here. We're going to do like sort of a Men in Black kind of look. So I'm going to warp his eyes, just exaggerate them a little bit. Looks kind of crazy. So you could use this for whatever kind of effect you want, whether it's something creative like this or just doing something subtle if you need to resize. So now he's got sort of this bug eye look. Now we're going to track this to the shot here. I want to move down to my tracker. Normally it's on window. It'll say tracker window right here. Well, on the right side, there's an effect tab. We're going to hit effect. So now it says tracker effect. And then in order to get this to work, you click this little arrow down here with the plus sign, and that adds a tracking point. We're going to move one over to one of his eyes. We're going to add another one, and we're going to move that one over to the other eye. Oops. Got to get that little crosshair in there. So now we have two crosshairs available over each eye. We're going to track this back and forth, and it does a pretty stellar job tracking. Let that run for a second. So now it's tracking forward and backward throughout the shot. Now to get rid of your on-screen controls here, in the bottom left of your preview window, under the effects, you could choose off. I like using shift tilde is the shortcut. And now if we play this back, we kind of got this odd looking bug eye effect, tracked and warped. So that's the first effect I wanted to show you. Second one is more like a flashback sort of effect. So here's our shot. We have just this guy talking from my classic First Blood. So we want to make it look like a flashback sequence. First effect we can use is this prism blur. So I'm going to drop that on. And this kind of gives you like this doubling kind of dual lens effect. And this is keyable. So if we move back to like here and we make a keyframe on the position and then move forward a little bit, and then use this little on-screen control to pull it out over to the side. You can see right around his face is quite a bit more doubling. And we made another keyframe down here. So now if we play it, we kind of got this weird doubling lens effect. Now I'm going to add another node here. We're going to disable this first node. So the second one I'm going to show you is motion trails. So we'll type in motion, drop in motion trails, and we can look here, especially if we go back through some fast movement on this newspaper or his head movement. So if you couple these together, you can actually increase the tails here or the trail length. So maybe we'll bring it back down. There's some other controls here on how you composite it, and you can move your motion around if you wanted to keyframe some of these as well, including the angle, a bunch of stuff. So let's just look at what it's doing on level 5. And then if we added this motion in, or I should say the prism blur, actually labeled it wrong, you kind of get this flashback looking scene. And then of course you can use the global blend to sort of split the difference and make it not so over the top of an effect, go a little more subtle. But now we got this look, kind of makes it look more dreamlike. So that's pretty much what I wanted to show you, is just a few of these motion effects. The grid tool, it's pretty neat. I've used that to like change a smile on a photo before, but it's pretty cool what you can do with it and isolate your warping effect right in there. All right, I hope that helps. Leave a comment down below if you got a video topic you want me to try a video on. And subscribe if you haven't. Really helps me out, helps my algorithm. And I'll talk to you guys on the next video. Thanks for watching.